the crowd here. So there's no doubt that part of what accounts for the energy and momentum and crowds that we're seeing is in opposition to this administration's policies. Now, George W. has been a great advertisement for the Democratic Party. But it is going to take more than a change of parties in the White House to truly turn this country around. Now, George Bush... George Bush and Dick Cheney may have perfected divisive special interest politics. They may have turned it into an art form, but they didn't invent it. It was there before they got to Washington. And if you and I don't stand up and challenge it in this election, it will be there long after they leave. I'm running for president because I don't believe in the cynical strategy that says, yeah, to divide this country into two in order to win an election. I believe it's time to find our stake in each other as Americans and unite this country around a common purpose. I think it's time for us to reach out for a common destiny. I don't believe that we can come together as Americans to do better. I don't think we can afford four more years of conventional Washington foreign policy thinking that led us into the misguided war. I believe it is time for us to engage with friends and enemies in a way that restores America's moral leadership and security in the world. I understand that some pundits consider this a symptom of my lack of experience. And I used to wonder what they meant by this, because this whole experience argument, because I've been fighting for people as a public servant for over two decades, as a community organizer, as a civil rights lawyer, as a constitutional law professor, as a state senator, and as a U.S. senator. But then I came to realize that to some folks in Washington, only the years you spend in Washington count as experience. And I think they're wrong about that. I don't know if you remember, there were a couple of guys named Cheney and Rumsfeld who had two of the longest resumes in Washington, and they led us into the worst foreign policy fiasco of a generation. Time served does not guarantee good judgment. A resume says nothing about your character. About a different kind of experience. The experience I bring to this race. My experience tells me that real change and progress comes not by dividing, but by bringing people together to get things done. Like when I worked with police officers and civil rights advocates to reform a death penalty system that had seen 13 innocent men placed on death row in Illinois. Or, and by the way, somebody in the House, Larry Marshall, from Stanford Law School, who worked with me on that, and I'm grateful for the outstanding work you did there and the outstanding work you're doing here. Well, when I worked with Republicans and Democrats to expand health care for 150,000 Illinoinans, or put $100 million worth of tax breaks in the pockets of working families who really needed it, instead of tax breaks from folks who didn't need it and weren't even asking for it. People's interests before the special interests and the partisan interests. That's what I did in Illinois when I took on money in politics and passed the first ethics reform in 25 years. That's what I did in Washington when I passed a law that earned me the cold shoulder from leaders of both parties. For the first time in history, Washington lobbyists will have to disclose who they're raising money from and who in Congress they're funneling it to. Because I think democracy works better when we know it's just exactly how the system's working. That's why I'm running this campaign without taking a dime of Washington lobbyist money, without taking PAC money. I want to hear your voice loud and clear when I'm making decisions in the White House.